We got
Taylor Swift featuring Chris Stapleton. I bet you think about me. Taylor's version.
I will never forget the first time that I met you. I thought, wowza, that is the most beautiful girl in the world. You had the sweetest eyes, the softest smile.
3 a.m. and I'm still awake. I'll bet you're just fine, fast asleep in your city. It's better than mine. And the girl in your bed has a fine pedigree. And I'll bet your friends tell you she's better than me. Yeah, they let me sit in back when we were in love. All they sit around talking about the meaning of life and the book that just saved them that I hadn't heard of. But now that we're done and it's over, I bet you couldn't believe when you realized I'm harder to forget. Then I was too late, and I bet you think about me. You grew up in a silver spoon gated community, glamorous, shiny, bright Beverly Hills. I was raised on a farm, no, it wasn't a mansion. Living room dancing and kitchen table bells. But you know what they say, you can't help who you fall for. And you and I fell like an early spring snow, but reality crept in.
Yo, her ability, like, I'm so engaged in this story that, like, she makes it so easy to, like, to tell a story as she's singing it, and I don't know why, but like this song has I just love the way that she like did this story, and like the music video is just perfect, and I love how she like brought the red scarf.
Yeah, and she obviously like she touches on classism a bit, right? Like she tells the story of like he comes from money, he comes from these mansions, he just comes from a different class of upbringing. People, he's an upper class, yeah. You know, it's a different upbringing, right? Where she came from a kitchen room table full of bills and just dancing on the table or something like that, which illustrates like that classic romantic storyline of like rich boy meets broke girl. You know, like just a classic Cinderella story, you know, minus the slippers.
Yeah, and I love that, you know, she's all dressed in red, and I instantly think about, you know, how you just can't help but focus on the red, right? So, like, for him, it's like it's his wedding day, but he just can't help but think about her. And, I just love that I love how the producer made this video, because it's just a great storyline. And I think they just drew it out really well.
But you know what they say, you can't help who you fall for. And you and I fell like an early spring snow, but reality crept in. You said we're too different. You laughed at my dreams, rolled your eyes at my jokes. Mr. Superior thinking, do you have all the space that you need? I don't have to be your shoes. to know that you'll never be happy. And I bet you think about me. You're looking for is the love that you had. Now you're out in the world, searching for your soul. Scared not to be hip, scared to get old. Chasing make-believe status, last time you felt free was when none of that shit mattered, 'cause you were with me. But now that we're done and it's over, I bet it's hard to believe. About me. $1 million couch. I bet you think about me when you say, oh my God, she's insane, she wrote a song about me. I bet you think about me.
Oh my gosh, it was directed by Blake Lively.
Who's Blake Lively?
She's an actress. She's Gossip Girl, the blonde girl.
Oh, I see.
That was really well directed.
Yeah, it was really good. Yeah, I mean, it's a really good story. That story of, like, you don't know what you have until you don't have it. Mm-hmm. And it's a situation where you're with someone, everything's good, you leave her in search of something else, but you realize that what's missing is not really who you're with, it's kind of like what's inside you. And then you realize afterwards that you would have been happy if you just kind of stayed with the person that you were with, but by the time you realize, it's just too late. And like everything transforming into red is, I think, illustrates Taylor Swift's transformation. Like, she's no longer the same person. When you first met her, she was maybe innocent, naive, maybe even a virgin, right? And that's why it's white. It's pure when it's white. That's like the sign of like purity. It's like very angelic. And then, you know, you take someone's virginity and then like kind of just, she transforms into a different person, a person that wouldn't take him back again. You know, and his wedding just goes from like white to like red. And you can see, like, it's a little bit, you can see she has a little bit of vengefulness in the scenario, but in a way where she's happy, she's moved on, and she's not afraid to show him that she's happier, and she's glad that it played out the way it did, as opposed to him, like, he's more on the regretful side. That's what I got out of it.
I love that, because what really stood out to me was the moment when she, like, when she realizes that everything in the surface was not what it really was, right? So like you think about the cake, for instance, it's all white outside, but the minute she like takes a chunk out of it, it's red. And for me, I started realizing that everything that was important to this guy was very surface related, right? Like the first line or the first verse talks about how the new woman that he's with has a good pedigree. Like it makes me think about like someone that has like really good genes, someone that will probably pass down like really beautiful kids. And some people are just really simple-minded in that way, where they just want someone that's like perfect so that they can pass down like really good genes, right? And then you kind of start realizing that, like, as she's, like you mentioned, transforms, everything turns into red. And I think that's just like exposing like the truth. Because the truth is like inside, which you don't realize until you like eat the cake, until he like kind of like has like that, that like that camera light like shine at him, and then he like starts fantasizing, and then it turns red and kind of illustrates, you know, the truth about how he's like thinking about her.
That's actually, wow, that's a really good interpretation now that I think about it, because like that flash, right, that flash is him being blinded by the truth. He actually sees, he sees what reality is, which is like, to your point, everything he was looking at, as Taylor said, is make-believe status. It's not real. It's make-believe. It's just this social construct that's like, there's no intrinsic value to that. It's just your perception of what you think is valuable, but really isn't. So yeah, that's a really good point. And that's why everything shifts from like his view being very external and just caring about perception, versus later on, it's more internal and him focused on like how he actually felt.
Right. And she even mentions it, right? She says something along the lines of, you didn't realize that this was, you realized all this wasn't important when you were with me, because it didn't matter when you were with me. Which makes sense, because she didn't come from that. So naturally, it's not going to be that important to her.
Yeah.
Or as important.
And only here, I remember that one line. The one line I liked a lot too is like, you're sitting down on your $1 million couch with your organic shoes, you know, which really illustrates like how pretentious he is and what he actually cares about, like organic shoes and a $1 million couch, you know.
Right.
And she also said that like he would roll his eyes at her dreams and wouldn't even laugh at her jokes, like as if she was beneath him. And he was, and as she said, like he was superior minded, or he perceived himself as superior minded, but he really wasn't. He was just really shallow. And that's all he was. He's like the equivalent of like Shallow Hal, if you remember Shallow Hal.
Yes,
which is a really great story. And it's just funny how your perception of things can really shift when you start to look at things from an internal level versus an external perspective, or at least a perspective of just shallowness as far as like status and material things go.
And I loved like the times that you hear Chris Stapleton in the background as he's kind of like echoing behind Taylor Swift. It was just perfect.
Yeah, it was really good. It was a great song, and it was very well directed. And as simple as Taylor Swift's videos are, they're so impactful, because just everything in the video is meaningful, right? Like there's not a lot of filler. It's simple, but you have just enough to tell the story, and me as a viewer, I'm only paying attention to the story. There's nothing outside of the story that's here. It's just very relevant.
And she just, she plays the part so well that like you forget that she's acting this out.
Right. Even the part where, remember when she gives the girl the box and the way, like her body language, like her body, in my opinion, her body language speaks volumes. It's just like, here, take this. Like, I don't want it. You can definitely have it. Yeah. You know, like, and that's the way she gave, like, the scarf. She put the scarf around her neck here. That's all you.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Like, I wouldn't, you couldn't pay me to take this back. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. And I can't help but think about the scarf symbolizing the guy, right? Almost.
Yeah. She's exactly.
Like, here, he's like, your problem. Now go ahead.
I think if we're relating it to the other video, it's the scarf that, like, actually one of the subscribers said the scarf symbolized her virginity. And I can almost run with that. Like, something that she gave to him.
She's giving it to her.
And then, like, he took it. Hold on.
He took that shit.
Yeah, he took it from her. And then, like, she doesn't. It's no longer meaningful to her. And then, yeah, now it's like the new girl. But actually, that wouldn't work if that was her virginity. But
no, I think in that storyline, it definitely made sense. This, I think the scarf definitely symbolizes it something else. But it was kind of like a haha moment when it's like a red scarf.
Yeah.
Because now, like, the red scarf can definitely symbolize something else, and I love that because it makes it very universal now, right? Because now we kind of think about what our red scarf is,
right
that it's given to someone.
I think it's just the symbol of what the relationship was, and that could be anything. It could be in the form of a promise ring, a gift of some sort. It could be anything. Maybe it was like a memory that they had. Mm-hmm. So it could literally be anything, but I think for sure it's a symbol of what their relationship was when it was good, is what I think. And it's why Taylor doesn't want to, she wouldn't move backwards. She wouldn't take that back. And that's why she was so eager to give to the new girl, which she's the one that's in that supposedly good relationship now. But maybe that, like, I don't know, for all we know, like, that girl doesn't even exist because she disappears later on in the film, right? It's actually Taylor. So really what he's in search for is his old relationship, and he's looking for it in other women.
I also really like him as an actor.
Where's he from again? Oh, he was from, what's not 13 Reasons Why.
Wasn't he in Mockingjay or Mockingbird?
No, hell. Oh, hold on. Maybe.
Or like one of those like Maze Runner things. Like one of those like dystopian teenage / young adult movies.
You know what it is? His look is kind of generic.
So no, he was in Divergent.
I think he was in Divergent.
Yeah.
And he could have been in all the movies all we them. Just listed.
He just has that, like.
Or maybe he was in none of those movies.
Yeah, no, he was definitely in either Divergent or Mockingjay. Sometimes I kind of mix them up.
I feel like he would have been in Mockingjay. And I also feel like he could have definitely been in Insurgents. That was a really good film, too.